Wow.
I was finna drink your shit.
That's a real party foul.
What?
Drinking a nigga water?
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck.
I got a right T on the top of my shit. Your shit was more fuller.
You said T on the top. I didn't get it. I'm like, what?
You never write your name on your bottle, nigga.
I always put it like around, like on this part.
Nigga. Some niggas be taking this off. Like, I'm a nigga with no paper on mine.
If a nigga arguing about water, I don't need to hang around a nigga. Like, come on, bro. This is some, that's some slavery.
Nigga, that's my water. But there'd be hella waters out here, half drunk in water. I'd have been in some situations. Like, come on. Now this is wasteful.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. When waters, when it's hella of them that look the same. You just gotta chalk that up to the game.
Right, you gotta barbecue, I gotta get a new one. Like just sitting on the table, nigga. Like,
hey. I just start fucking with like bottled water.
What you was drinking out the tap?
Yeah, I never like cared about like what type of water and shit. Like growing up, like.
Yeah, I didn't get good grown until I'd be like, no, I like spring water.
Yeah, when you start fucking with like water, like certain waters, because I didn't get. I thought it was stupid to pay for water because I'm like, you can get water for free. Like, you can, nigga, in the kitchen. You know what I'm saying? All type of shit. The water fountain. Like, I was
wondering. A lot is starting to make sense, Lou.
Huh?
A lot is starting to make sense. You been drinking tap water this whole time?
Until I got grown down there, not. About 20.
That's a long ass time, dog. Did nobody in your house drink regular water? I mean, not regular water, but.
Shit, niggas drink out. We had to.
I feel okay after a certain year, after bought. Like 2004. Yeah, I think it, nigga, you know. Before 2005, I think that water was some of the best water to ever come across in the world. The 90s tap water, that's pure. That's.
Oh, mama.
That's damn near alkaline right there. Nigga, you used to be by the water hose, nigga, just going crazy. But that's, after 05 ish?
You was buying water. That's what I consider, like, nigga grew up, of course, drinking bottled waters, but I'm talking about buying a water. Like, I never bought a water, nigga, growing up. I'm like, hell no, I'm going to drink some water, nigga.
At the water fountain. Nigga be at the fountain for 3 minutes.
Yeah, nigga, I'm getting Arizona sodas, hella shit. Shit, I can't get for free. I didn't get the logic of buying water until I got adult. Like, nah, let me, like, you damn near.
That's because you almost got to pass out, nigga, and need it.
Yeah.
Nigga fuck around, be out all day, drinking and shit, get dehydrated. Boy. Yeah. That's why niggas who don't like, water's disgusting. Nigga, ain't nobody drinking water, nigga, for it to taste bomb, nigga. You drink water to live, nigga.
And that's what the thing I wasn't fucking with, too. People used to, like, talk about, like, this water tastes hella better. But I'm starting to peak that, though.
Yeah, certain waters. That's why I say spring waters. Uh-huh. Fuck, it's a water with an orange cap. And it got mountains on it. La Panina. That's some good ass water. I don't know if I'm saying it.
Panina.
I don't know if I'm saying it. You just said
Mexican drink.
That ain't water. Pineapple soda.
Nigga, that's pineapple juice. Man.
Hell no. Low key it is though.
Yeah, I know with the little shit.
I don't know. Somebody in the comments gonna be this dumb ass.
I like Fiji. People be trying to roast me because I like Fiji water, but that's
Fiji
cool.
Solid.
Yeah,
Essentia solid. Korai. Evian though. Evian is that's the baddest bitch out there to me.
I like buying that smart water. Ain't that? It's called smart water.
It is called smart water.
I like that shit because it just looked like a nigga just hella mature, grown.
And that's where they get hella they sales from. Yeah. That water terrible.
Hell, mama, nigga, I got the smart water. That nigga shit. Look like a grown ass man. Nigga just walking with a smart water and shit.
It's how nothing but special needs niggas drink that water.
That's why I'm slow. I'm drinking smart water.
Smart water turn your body back. I stayed away from smart water. I was like, oh, hell no. I think my first sip of smart water, I felt dumber.
That's some new shit, huh? Smart water? What's up with all this smart shit? Smart car, smart phone, smart water?
It's because being smart ain't popping no more. Like, you used to be a smart. If you were smart, you was a celebrity back in the day. Albert Einstein, that nigga had hoes, nigga, off science.
Ooh.
All that shit, nigga. Ain't no. who the top scientists of the world? We know Fauci, the nigga from the CDC.
The scientists is the motherfuckers that making the apps now. And them niggas got bitches. What's the name? What's brother name that made Instagram and Facebook? Bro, why am I forgetting? Zuckerberg? Zuckerberg. He got bitches.
Do we though?
Yeah, he got, you know he got bitches because he fucking bitches that we don't even know.
Right, and he's Facebook, so he know their whole life.
He know everybody, bitch. So he ain't picking no bitches.
He
we
fucking
know
everybody, bitch. He fucking all our bitches. Our aunties.
Hold on, I got my mama information. Right. My mama got a Facebook. Hold on, nigga. Damn, that's crazy. He got our information. He can really.
That's why Boosie bad right now.
Oh my, he really know Boosie. Like,
Boosie be talking shit directly at them niggas, and they'll be like, nigga, your pay is gone tomorrow.
Yeah.
And then he'll come back the next day with a new pay. They gonna shut down that nigga IP address. He ain't gonna be able to get an Instagram login on his whole block, nigga.
Boosie still gonna be getting some money.
Still.
Damn. That just tripped me out though, bro. He got everybody information. They say he lost $7 billion or some shit because Instagram.
He worth $130, nigga. That's like, nigga, you lose a stack, nigga, but if I got $100, I would like to have that stack back. That feels good, but.
What's up with, what you think happened with the Instagram? Because y'all know Instagram got shut down for like a day.
I don't know. This little woke bitch I fuck with said Mercury was in retrograde.
I don't even know what the fuck that means.
She was like, the planets is aligning and knocking off the solar plexus of the internet. And that's why she cussed the bitch out at Starbucks that morning. It just be an excuse to be an asshole for a day.
What? For Instagram to shut down?
No, for Mercury to be a retrograde. They just...
I don't know what you're talking about, Ted.
It's woke. It's you gotta...
Really... I'm OG 70s, 80s woke. That's like some whole other shit.
You not the new age woke?
Yeah, I'm not new age woke. Nigga.
When they
I know
ask
about
you what
Black
your
Panthers
pronouns
and...
is when you pull up?
Yeah, yo.
What's your pronoun?
Yeah.
I was like, where they get? Like, what the hell?
That's what I'm going to say. I'm Lewis. I'm from the Bay. I don't know what you're talking about.
I was at a, shout out to No Name. I was at her library launch. She launched the Hood Radical Library, which is dope. Like, you know. I don't know too many people, young people, caring about shit enough to open a library that's free for the public.
That's raw.
You know?
That's raw. And it's hella books that's been, like, people still releasing books and shit, so.
Still?
Yeah.
Like, albums, nigga.
Yeah.
Yes. And she sent hella books to jails, so, you know.
Shout out to her. What's her name?
No Name.
No Name. That's some gangster shit.
I'm gonna post a link to her Patreon so y'all can support in the comments.
That's some gangster shit.
Yeah. But she really doing real shit, bro. She had different kind of nationalities, all kind of people, older, younger. However,
that's
just
how
everybody
black people judge
your
success. It was other people from different races there.
Yeah, nigga, whole turbans. I'm talking nigga full turbans.
You got white people coming out.
That's what niggas gave your success.
Oh, mamas, if white people fuck with you, you own.
Oh, nigga, I didn't know it was like this.
Yeah.
Like, because I don't know why niggas still feel like in their mind they got to act different when white people is present.
And I hate that.
I think it's a, you got to be more mature and when you're in a setting of strangers anyway.
Yes.
That should, nigga, you don't know these people. Don't, yeah. But niggas like, it's all niggas. You know, it's a comfort. I
treat white people how I treat black people. Like, if I'm cussing in mid-conversation and a white person walk by me, I'm still cussing. Nigga, I'm free. I don't like when people are shh. Like, nigga, we was just at the barbecue. We was cussing. Nobody said shh. Nigga, now we at this motherfucking Starbucks and niggas want me to shh. Nigga, what?
You do got a voice that carry. I remember when we was on that flight, nigga, to 6 in the morning to Denver. This nigga loud in the motherfucker. Niggas act like they can't be lit in here. Nigga, I'm like, niggas asleep. we got a 6 a.m. flight. Niggas trying to go back to sleep.
You was just tired. I had my regular voice. Your ass was just sleepy.
Nah, nigga. I think I was.
You know, when you sleepy, shit be hella loud.
That's what
you
I'm be saying.
Like, bruh. That's how your face gets. When you sleepy, nigga, your shit be like this when people start talking. I'm like, bruh. Lower your motherfucking voice, nigga.
Man.
That shit be a buzz. Oh, mama. Nigga said 6 in the morning flight to Denver.
You got my mama, nigga.
And you had all your niggas from the bank with you. So you was even more juice.
You have, yeah, I do be juice when my niggas be going places.
But you ain't never seen no shit like this, nigga.
But your joke at the Young OG show last month was hella funny.
What I do?
Bro, you said bank niggas all talk like, you said you could be deaf and you'll know a nigga from the bank, because a nigga just be like, yeah, bro. Bro, that shit had me rolling.
Yeah.
It was like, you can't even hear, but you know a nigga from the bank. Nigga talking about.
Bank niggas stay having shit on their bar.
So I told the bitch.
I skirt off, nigga. Whoa. You know.
Oh, shit, bro. That's hella funny. Nah, shout out to everybody that came out to the Young OG show.
You hey, man, shout out. These Young OG shows, we get more and more star-studded, bro.
Yeah, Corey Holcomb slid.
Corey Holcomb slid. 19 Keys slid.
19 Keys. Shout out 19 Keys.
Marcus bro. Pope for Boeisha slid.
Yeah, I didn't see him, bro.
I'm sorry I lied to you, Mark.
Damn.
That nigga's a legend, bro.
I'm hella mad you see it. You get a pick, you can take a pick.
Nah, I ain't get a flick. I gotta get better at that. I'm bad.
You do.
I'm learning, but now I'm like,
I gotta. Teddy, bro, it ain't Boosie. You know, nigga, if you feel like it's Boosie, that I'm working on it too, though. Because I be really taking the picks for my mama, though.
For a purpose, like, so my mama was like, won't look at my son.
Yeah, she be trying to be like, look at my son and all this shit. Right. You feel me? So I'm like, let me. When I see certain niggas, I'm like, because
other niggas, because her friend's sons ain't on shit.
They ain't doing shit.
So she need your pictures to verify.
My son. My mom be taking you, send this pic. Send me that picture. Okay, I got you. She be on Facebook, hella shit.
Brandon.
Talking her shit. She got the rights. On mama's, nigga. Because when I was doing bad, she had to hear everything. On mama's. Mama.
Yeah, moms can brag, man.
Yeah, your mama called me at the show because your cousin's trying to get in or something.
Oh, yeah, she called.
She was like, Theodore is not there. So, these people need to get in. I'm like, you know, were you like confused because your mama calling you? Like, she's not calling you Teddy.
Right.
So it's like,
who the fuck is Theodore?
Yeah, like.
She said it like she had an attitude. That's the.
I already knew what she was talking about because I'm like, yo, mama ain't calling me for no motherfucking reason. She trying to get in contact with you.
So no, like, what had happened was she had contacted me. I said, mama, I'm 4 minutes away from the club.
Mm-hmm.
I can't speed up and hurry to get these niggas inside the club. She making it. Try to accommodate these niggas from the phone from Vegas. I'll get them in there when I get there. Like, that's what I was going to do. But, you know, everything.
Your mom called press and shit. I'm like, damn. But, you know, I'm used to it because my mom be pressing. So I'm like, okay. I got it. I'm going to talk to Ted.
And we be kicking it. So I feel like your mama got a comfortability to really tell you the truth. The same way your mama be kicking it to me raw. Like,
yeah.
Whatever I need to tell you, dog. This ain't what's going to happen. Young man. Like, you know.
Oh, mama.
Yes, ma'am. That's all you can say.
It'd be hella pressure. I was hella scared too, because I'm like, your mama usually don't call. So I'm like, what this nigga getting into? I know this nigga just bought new whip and hella shit. I'm like, this nigga, I don't know what's going on. Nigga, tell me what's going on before I answer that phone.
Everything kosher, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Everything kosher.
Damn, bro. So IG back,
niggas was shook for a second. They ain't had no identity.
Yeah, bro, that's crazy. I was not panicking. I was chilling. I knew it was going to come back, though. So that's what it was, too.
When I say that day was comfortable, little bitch, I didn't sweat. I didn't miss nothing.
What'd you do?
I think I just rode around the city, bro, and smoked.
Mm-hmm.
I might have went somewhere. play some 2K or something, but I wasn't like
normal day. Yeah, I went to the grocery store while Instagram was shut down, and I was getting ready for the show. I was like, I'm like, all right, this shit probably gonna be working.
Low key, I meditated too. That little
for real.
I was like, oh, this must be a sign to meditate.
You hella deep. Oh, this is a sign to meditate.
No, because what had happened is I woke up and I thought my Wi-Fi had shut down. Because first thing I checked was Instagram.
Yeah.
So I was like, to me, that's kind of like a trigger. Like
you don't need to be.
I don't need to be. That don't need to be a first thought of the day type shit.
I ain't gonna lie, happened to me too.
You know, so it really it just sparks up in my head. Like, all right, nigga, like. But my phone be right there. I just be laying, you know, you just want to scroll. And, all right, I'm up. Let me see what the world talking about, you know.
Niggas treat apps like bitches. As soon as Instagram shut down, I'm like, let me get on Twitter and see if this shit working.
But I've been on Twitter. I be on Twitter more than I be on Instagram anyway.
But you don't be tweeting.
I tweet every now and again, but Twitter is.
I don't like typing.
That, and it's a different timing of joke on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
And you really got to.
And I don't want to get caught up in saying nothing on Twitter. Niggas be getting in trouble off Twitter. Like,
that's because they get on Twitter and treat that shit like a diary, nigga. Yeah. Like, no, nigga. Treat this shit like.
Twitter like a public air thought, nigga. Twitter like hella captions. And I'm bunk at captions. So it's like, man, nigga, this all captions? I gotta like get people.
It's a lot. It's grown. It's a lot of think pieces now. It's a lot of arguing. Twitter used to be just for roasting and putting motherfuckers on blast. Like,
yeah.
Like I feel like niggas get put on blast quicker on Twitter than they would do on any other site. Shit I see on IG is the shit I see on Twitter from hours ago.
Damn.
Or days ago, even.
Yeah, man, I be struggling with Twitter. And it's hard, too, because it's like, you can't even knock bitches on Twitter.
Shit.
How you gonna knock a bitch on Twitter?
What you mean? Hello? Hi? Nigga?
On the timeline? Because people don't, no. People be checking their messages and
sometimes. Some girls be, you know, no, I ain't checking them. But if you that nigga.
Y'all put a comment. Have y'all ever knocked a bitch on Twitter? Like the DM, like. Message somebody on Twitter and then get their line. Because there ain't enough pictures on Twitter.
So no. People post. People post thousands of pictures. You got to go all the way to the media section and just scroll.
Oh, yeah. Bro.
This nigga.
I don't be on that shit, bro.
Okay, let me go to it.
Have you knocked some bitches on Twitter?
You know, God is good.
You ain't knocking no bitches on Twitter. You knocking shit on Instagram.
Hey, bro. I knock more off Instagram, but yeah.
Is what I'm saying. I fuck around. I fuck with Facebook more than Twitter, damn near.
Hey, Facebook got the.
Facebook be going. Any of you have a little funny videos? See, that's what I'm saying. That takes hella long.
No, I just had to find a lady that was like
she
you know,
going crazy. Right. I be seeing that be Twitter like a little porn website too. Sometimes, hella sex, hella shit on Twitter.
So you know, she raw. Boom. And then you go through her page.
And then DM.
You see how she talk. You be like, oh, okay, she joke like this. She, okay, bam, bam, bam. It's almost a cheat code. Because you go back a couple tweets and be like, oh, this is what she like to talk about. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. You in there, nigga. You already know. I can just go, just, you know. Type, I'm, okay. I don't even want to drop this game.
What?
It's damn near creepy. You can type a girl's Twitter name and then type, like, next to it, like, my favorite. Look up all whatever she done tweeted about her favorite whatever. Go through
what?
It. I done did that, bro.
So, type in her name.
And then space my favorite. And then whatever she tweets, like, my favorite movie is whatever. My favorite do-do-do whatever. So, then you can just come with a movie quote from her favorite movie. You know?
Ooh, that's kind of deep. That ain't creepy. It's creepy if you a nerd.
Yeah, if your attention's
if you a player, that's doing some research on me.
Right,
yeah.
I remember a chick told you her favorite cologne was this, to smell on a nigga. Guess who went and bought that shit?
My favorite cologne is Versace.
It was sitting next to all that shit. Yeah, bitch.
Oh, mamas. That's hella funny.
Nah, Twitter's lit, though.
You seen the video with, it was a female and a guy, and they was dating each other, and, it was a white dude asking a question, like, how long y'all been together? And then, bro, like, a year and a half. And he like, y'all trust each other? And he was like, yeah. He was like, all right, if y'all trust each other, switch phones right now for 30 seconds. Bro whipped out his phone like, yeah, all right, it's good. Let's do it. The girl next to him like, my phone. I got to go get my phone. Bro already looked like, huh?
They might have been at a little picnic something at the beach.
Nah. Where your phone at the beach? I mean, like, it looked like it was at a fair.
Oh, yeah. If it's at a fair, I don't know.
Bitch, where your phone at? Stop playing with me.
All I'm saying, it had to be around somebody that they know for her to leave it.
Yeah, yeah.
So they there with some other people.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
So, boom. So, for the people that don't know the rest of the shit. So, the female go get her phone. Boom. So, both of them got their phone. They switch phones. Bruh. Looking at her phone, and he starts saying hella niggas' names. Like, who Jeff? Who Rodney?
Jacob. Jingleheimer Schmidt. All them niggas.
Female hit him with the, what? Like, you serious? That's how you know when a bitch jaws it. When you, like, question her about something, and then she like,
I can't believe you would even.
So, boom. So, bruh, like, hold on. He sent a little text message. Two or three dudes sent her some money. She asked. It was like $50, $90 here, all the shit. And bruh got hot, and he grabbed the phone, and, you know, bruh was embarrassed. He looking hella stupid. You know, for the people that seen the video, they know what I'm talking about. For the people that haven't seen it, go on my Instagram, Lou Do Too Much. I posted it because I thought the shit was hilarious. my thing is, I wanted to ask you, Ted. So, you seen the video, right?
Yeah.
Do you consider that as cheating if a female go behind your back
and get $90 from another nigga?
Several niggas. That's cheating, right?
Yes. Because it's like, what? How? You just got three friendly niggas in your life, just, here go 90. Now, if it was one, we could talk about it.
Uh-huh.
Three?
Damn.
And even that one, we gonna have to really talk.
Like, one, bitch. Hold on, bitch.
Who is this nigga?
But at the same time, on his end, I don't think it was player for him to go through her phone. But that it was a game.
Yeah.
Yeah, on some game, because I don't think.
But that's what happens, bro. You play games, sometimes you end up losing. You put your quarters in that machine, nigga, and it say game over.
But that was like, that was the type of game that was on the spot. Nobody, they wasn't expect. That's like, you know, when people sit at the games, like the little basketball games.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all agreed to play. You saw the camera.
Yeah.
You saw that. You know these niggas is not finna stop filming. No matter what y'all say.
Yeah, and I don't think niggas would agree to be like, I don't know. If I'm in a relationship.
And it's the internet. You don't need no, what's that shit they make niggas sign for TV? Like the release forms and shit?
Yeah.
You ain't gotta, what? Yeah. Save, nigga? Dropbox, nigga?
Have you ever went through a female phone? Don't lie.
One time.
Uh-huh. Never what made again. You go through the phone? And how did you feel after you went through the phone?
I was young when I went through the phone. Let me think what I was doing when I was going.
Because I kind of feel like
I might have been insecure. And probably insecurity. She was fine as fuck. And uh-huh. I was just like, what are you doing here? I had them kind of thoughts.
Uh-huh.
So, you know.
You had to find out. Like, yeah. Do this bitch really like me?
Is she playing me?
Yeah.
Like, you know.
I typed did you find shit anything?
No.
Really?
She, it was some nigga had hit her. She didn't respond.
What?
Basically, like, you know. And I expect shit like that. Because nigga. If you cute, niggas is gonna hit you
hell
up.
Hell yeah.
But she wasn't responding.
Bro, what? For real? That's hella impressive. So then you felt dumb?
Dumb.
Damn. What's funny, man? So even if you find something or you don't find something, you gonna feel dumb
regardless.
You gonna
feel stupid either way. So just don't look.
Damn, for real?
Don't look. Just, you know. Because, like, bro, if we really a couple, like, if we really in this thing together, not you, nigga, fuck that. But, like, if we really in this relationship, like, what is this? This ain't, I'm not dating this.
Bro, that's crazy. That's hard for me to believe that she wasn't talking to nobody, Ted.
It was hard for me to believe, nigga, like.
She had to be deleting shit.
She was, maybe she, a lot of women be on their pimping, too. So, kudos to her for being on her shit.
Yeah, but we can't just, shout out to her. You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna say her name. But shout out to her because we can't just throw that on her. You know what I'm saying? You didn't find nothing. She wasn't doing that. Damn.
And what made me think, like, maybe she didn't delete it. Or maybe she left it, like, on some, here's a sprinkle of evidence. Was the nigga that hit her, she didn't respond.
Yeah. And only reason, she wasn't moving wrong. She didn't really even do nothing. It was just, she's so raw. It's like, hold on, bitch. One of them.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Yeah, because I kind of feel like I went through that. Not on the other end. Like, I never went through a female phone, but a female, I thought about it, but I'm like, hell no, bro. Like, pride wouldn't let me grab somebody's phone and look through it. It was an ego thing for me. Because I'm like, only reason I'm thinking about it is because I'm like, bro, this is her second time going through my phone. Like, bitch, I'm not doing nothing. So what is you doing? You obviously doing something.
If you keep going through
my phone. If you going through my phone, you ain't finding nothing. You must really be doing something. You can't believe it that I'm not doing that.
Well, in your defense, yeah.
But but to your point is probably because a nigga saucy. It's probably like it's not possible this nigga not fucking with nobody else.
And women have been there before. They done been fucked over by so many niggas.
Yeah.
I realize the reason why relationships don't work when niggas really try and get a full all, y'all don't believe.
Yeah.
And then when a nigga play games and bullshit, that's when y'all be the most
you try to be all good.
Right. When a nigga really go hard in the paint for his love, nigga, y'all don't appreciate that shit. Well, not y'all, a large percentage.
95%.
Yeah.
Women.
Because it's almost like you don't believe in good is going to happen in your life. So you got to sabotage it in some way.
Yeah.
So I feel like I did with the bad bitch, going through her phone.
Yeah.
Just simp-minded shit, nigga. Yeah. Just not realizing, like, nah, nigga, you somebody that she want to be next to.
Yeah.
She chose me.
Oh, mamas. That's crazy.
Before the Teddy Ray shit, too.
Yeah, the movement. Nigga.
Before ADD and all that shit, nigga.
Damn.
So.
That's crazy. Yeah, out of 10 women, right, I was saying, like, I feel like 9 of them fucking with another nigga, getting some money from another nigga, all type of shit in this era. I think this era is the worst batch of females ever in history.
They probably could say the same, though, about us.
I think so, too.
Right.
But niggas been, niggas ain't never been shit.
But we had more skills back then. We ain't got enough skills now.
That's niggas. A fact. Niggas is bunker too.
Right. So it's this like the worst. World.
Yeah, this might be. You think this the worst batch of men?
It's the worst. We the worst of the worst right now. Because we a reflection of what's happening.
I feel. Because niggas is hella feminine. They're not leaders. Because I like being around. I like just dealing with women just with business and all type of shit more than men because women is more responsible and they speak up more than niggas now.
Man.
So it's a bad thing when, like, I guess you in a relationship with one because it's like, bitch, I don't need no alpha female running me and telling me what the fuck to do. I'm a man. I'm cool. But on some business shit, I love it. You know what I'm saying? So it's like.
So you saying you wouldn't take a boss as a wife?
Oh, no, my wife would have to be a boss. But I'm saying she would respect me as a man. And but I would be the leader of my household.
In her world.
She an alpha female. So you an alpha when you're around the women. Mm. You're not going to be the alpha around me and the males. You know what I'm saying?
And that's all we... Calm that shit down when you get to the house. All that rah-rah, leave that for them. We supposed to be in harmonious around this motherfucker.
Yeah, I want you to check everybody and then get to me and be like, hey, babe. You know what I'm saying? You're like, shut your ass up, nigga. Hey, babe. You feel me? Like, okay, yeah. You know my girl be tripping. You know what I'm saying? Let me explain to the niggas. Like, let me go hide my niggas, man. You know. You know what I'm saying? I got that. You know what I'm saying? Hey, baby. This such and such. It's my man. Don't be. You know what I'm saying?
Don't be getting out of line.
Don't be getting out of line. You know what I'm saying? So, that's the thing. It's like, women feel like they just talking to all niggas the same.
And that's not, no.
It's niggas that out here that drop their nuts you can't talk to like that. You know. So, I think it's great for business right now. But, relationship-wise?
You said it's great. Oh, this is good for the economy?
Yeah, yeah. Because
niggas keep buying these purses. Niggas keep accessorizing.
I don't know. It's just a finesse era.
This is accessories. I like these glasses. I wouldn't cop these, nigga. I was like, okay.
I fuck with that.
I feel like I'm about to hop in a Missy Elliott video, nigga.
That's how you know a nigga happy and shit, when a nigga start wearing just out of the ordinary shit.
I was all in the service pool with these on, nigga. Niggas were staring at me. Who is this, nigga?
This nigga in the hood in L.A. with some Kanye West glasses.
Man, Wesley Snipes had on a Kung Fu fit.
Kung Fu fit. Oh, you seen him? And that's what he had on?
He had, it wasn't a Kung Fu fit. He just had a burgundy outfit with hella Chinese writing on it.
I ain't seen Wesley Snipes since the 90s. What that nigga been doing?
He was in Coming to America, too.
Nah, that's Eddie Murphy, right?
Wesley Snipes was in there, too.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
That shit was weak. That movie was
hell. Brooklyn's Finest. A couple other movies he's been doing since he's been out for them taxes.
I didn't know the difference between Eddie Murphy and Wesley Snipes until I got damn near like 16.
You thought that was the same nigga?
I thought it was one nigga going crazy. Like, damn, this nigga ain't every movie.
Hell no.
Oh, shit. You watched the Hip Hop Awards?
I watched some of it, bro. I was out and about. I had a show last night, so I couldn't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but you watched it?
Yeah, I was chill. I watched it. I don't watch them type of shits. Like, all that shit watered down now. But I watched it because 85 South Show hosted it. So I'm like, it ain't going to be watered down. It's going to be
Hey, faucet. I saw the monologue I seen from them. It was funny.
Yeah, I watched it. They did a good job. Shout out
to the 85 South
Shout
Show.
Shout out to the whole squad. Yeah, that shit was legendary. It was hella raw. I never even seen it hosted like that because all three of them hosted it as one. So it was raw. That shit was different. So they did hella good.
And that's what the people need. Different.
Yeah.
We always been having the same old
shit. Nigga, Terrence Howard and what's Morris Chestnut. I love everybody, but I'm tired of seeing them niggas like. Shit been better because there's been new faces like Snowfall, Franklin the lead, and Power. Like, you know what I'm saying?
A lot of these shows right now, they requesting, like, no, we don't want no old heads.
Yeah.
Fresh faces. We'll have an old head as a recurring character.
Yeah, let that nigga be like a little uncle that come in the cameo. Don't just, niggas ain't trying to watch. Just.
Because it makes the characters more believable. If I'm sitting up watching Morris Chestnut be this nigga, this drug kingpin. I can't see that nigga. He been Morris Chestnut my whole life.
Yeah, I done seen this nigga play too many roles. Right. So I'm not gonna believe it.
Just let that nigga, you know, which sucks for, that's why they call it typecasting. Because it almost, the general public only wants to see you in one way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, you know, for a lot of artists, that's hell.
Yeah, that's bunk.
Cause I want to switch it up, nigga.
Yeah.
Some niggas don't mind doing the same shit, getting that.
But
shit.
At the same time, it's like, bro, if you've been in the game for 20 years, bro, start making your own movies and make the role. Like, you know what I'm saying?
That
like,
shit sound good, Lou.
It sound good, but it's hard.
Yes.
Bro, them niggas been in hella movies though, bro. Come on, hella.
And they still waiting to hear about when the next book gonna start casting.
That's what's wrong with the game. You don't hear rappers do that. Hip hop not like that. They be signing artists and shit like that. Like, it's like, I think actors need to put other actors in position to be actors and and bigger platforms. You know what I'm saying? Even with comedy. It's like,
bro. Niggas be scared of that competition, bro. They be like, man, if I help you out and then you pop, what you gonna help me when you know?
Yes, nigga. I'm gonna help you if you help me. What the fuck?
Because I helped other niggas and they didn't help me back.
I'll be like, all right, nigga, who you help?
Well, I'm not talking about me. I'm just talking about...
No, I'm saying them niggas. Right. Just in general. Like, Yo Gotti. Like, he put on Moneybag Yo and 42 the hella people, right, under CMG. Nigga, you don't think Yo Gotti's in a better position now than then? Dr. Dre. You don't even hear Dr. Dre. Dr. Dre don't even go outside no more.
Man.
Because he done put on so many rappers.
Now let's just take a bitch to dinner.
Oh, mama's, huh? And that's some player shit. You don't want to live like that?
Hey, man.
I love everybody, but it's time to step it up, brothers.
Hey. All I'm saying is, niggas, we got to get our skills up. Everybody just got to really... I think, what the world is shifting is and what I think they want us to be is they want everybody to be self-isolated and not need nothing, nobody, no contact. Because they try to slow down all this fucking. Because it's population control, bro.
Yeah. I'm already knowing. That's why they pushing that, you feel me, that little community so, they fucking around in.
That's why they
pushing. Because they don't want niggas to be recreating. You know what I'm saying? So they're going to have a nigga like Lil Nas X be the face of the movement and promote that movement to make the youth not want to fuck with women because it's too many motherfuckers. All
right. That's not what I was talking about. That had nothing to do with it.
That's how I feel. They don't want us to recreate. So, they going to want men to fuck with men. Because you don't hear gay people having babies and shit, right?
They adopt.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to shut the fuck up. Because I don't know what the fuck they be going on. I love everybody so much. I love everybody.
Anywho. I don't even know where we was at.
I don't know where we was going either.
You was taking it there. That's why I would let you talk, nigga.
I'm at the end of the day. What? You see what Dave Chappelle said? You seen the...
the special? Yeah,
I ain't seen the special.
I fell asleep on it twice.
Really?
No disrespect, Dave. I just, you know.
Really?
I pull up to the house late. I smoke a blunt. I get about 20, 30 minutes in. And then... But it's the house fault. It's the timing that I choose to pick.
You fall asleep on a lot of shit. You fall asleep on this podcast right now.
No.
You done dead near doze off one episode.
Almost.
You know.
Almost, but you know, whatever.
Big niggas always dozing off hella fast. You mid conversation. I talk to this nigga Ted. So, yeah, man, I'm finna graduate out of college, man. Nigga just.
That ain't that fast.
You be falling asleep fast, man. But I was saying that the Dave Chappelle said something I agree with. I didn't watch the whole special, I just seen the clip. I'm gonna have to watch it. But he was basically saying, like, bruh. The baby that shot and killed the nigga. You know what I'm saying? And nobody had a problem with it. He didn't get canceled. He killed the nigga.
And rapped about it.
And rapped about it. And did it.
Made me dance to it.
You know what I'm saying?
Made me.
Don't make me do it again. All this shit. He hurt some gay people's feelings off a comment. Some things he said. And they try to cancel him. That show you the value of niggas.
That's why I be telling niggas, just pick your words wisely, nigga. Unless you got a... Dave can do what he does because he knows how to pick his words wisely.
Exactly.
Everybody can't go on a tangent about their feelings.
On mamas.
So, you know.
That's a fact. Good advice, Teddy. Because that's the shit I be working on. That's why I like to be the fuck quiet because I'm like, you don't want to hear my thoughts. But...
It ain't even the thoughts. It's just like, what are you adding value to the situation? Like, or are you just causing further?
I just want everybody to be free. I don't like people being scared to be who they is. So if people gay, let them be gay and let them be openly gay. But if niggas not gay, niggas should be openly be like, I'm not gay and I don't fuck around like that. And it should be offend anybody.
Right.
That's the shit I be on. Like, you know, I don't want, you feel me,
that's what I think. Straight. I don't think they care about, people. Nigga. If you say, hey, I'm straight, nigga, they not gonna be like, oh, you straight. That's what's funny. I'm offended. It's like when you question they gay shit.
But I don't feel like this.
Why would this nigga choose dick out of all this pussy in the world? Bro, I've been hearing these comments my entire life, bro. Like, not even like all my uncles talk reckless. Everybody, all these, you know, and it's not nothing. Like, I understand. Coming from a nigga who was around people that didn't understand gay people, to me, a 10-year-old, 9-year-old kid finding out at school, nigga, the nigga I've been kicking it with the most, this nigga chose or accepted his gay calling.
Yeah.
And I had to be like, you still my nigga, because you a solid dude.
Yeah.
Whatever, I don't know what you're talking about right now, because we 11, 12.
Yeah.
It wasn't Lil Nas X out right there. Like, there's nothing you could... It wasn't no, whatever this influence is, niggas like, Lil Nas X is making niggas gay. No, he is not. Niggas is gay.
That's a fact.
Niggas is gay.
I agree on that. I agree on that. But what about the kids?
The kids is gay. Damn. They just was fighting it before.
You don't think it's more gay people now than...
I think the gay number is damn near... I feel like the women spike it more. I think it's the women is really upping the gay shit. But I don't know on the niggas. I don't know.
Yeah, because I kind of feel like that shit, it's not a problem in real life.
Especially when Girls Want Girls came out. Yeah. Lesbianism went up about 32%. She said that you're a lesbian girl, me too.
You think so?
I'm a lesbian right now. According to when I sing that song, I don't know.
It's just a weird ass time. I love everybody. I don't think this is problems in real life, though. I never hear gay people and straight people arguing in real life or having any type of disagreements. This is some social media shit.
Because this is where people feel safe enough to vouch they inner.
I kind of feel like if you straight, you argue with somebody that's gay, that's kind of gay. Like, why the fuck is you argue with his feelings and how he feel about?
I feel like if you care about where another nigga puts his shit at,
yeah,
whatever he does, that's what are you thinking about?
Yeah, and that's why me personally, it'd be hard for me to speak on certain shit because I don't know what everybody be doing.
Even like sex with women, right? You never be around your niggas when you was a kid, and like when you was a kid, you don't really be excited about some pussy. Now your boy tell you got some pussy. If he go into detail, you'd probably be like, all right, nigga, that's too much.
Yeah, too much information.
Like,
I'm
happy you getting it, nigga, but I don't care like that.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, that's what's up. Like, we not fucking too. Like, you know.
Only people that be doing that type of shit, those niggas that don't be getting no pussy. You just juice that you hit something. Like, all right, nigga. You juice. Damn. I think just social media is just making everybody voice their opinion. So it just seems like it's more of everything.
Yeah,
it seems like it's more women. It's more saucy niggas. It's more bad
and
bitches.
And it's a lot too, not just more social media, it's your intake.
Mm-hmm.
I think that whole Instagram shutting down,
mm-hmm.
your intake of social media. If you go right now on your phone and look at the how many hours, whatever you've been on each app, it'll tell you.
Mm-hmm.
You've been on Instagram for 3 hours today. You've been on this and this for... Like, if you add that shit up, nigga, you done spent, at the end of the month, nigga, you done spent a cool 3 days.
Yeah.
Just on IG, nigga, you done gave IG 3 days of your life.
On mamas. That's some real shit.
And you gotta think, bro, like, you just be scrolling. Niggas be like, you know, why can't I get a clear thought? Why can't I have a...
I see some funny shit on Twitter with Instagram shut down. Somebody tweeted, all the females got they body done for no reason now. You gotta think about it like shit.
It ain't for no reason. It's a nigga out there buying that shit in real life. But that's their biggest marketer for sure.
I don't know. It's a lot of females paying for their own shit now. I think the first original batch, you know, when females was getting their body done, niggas was paying for it. Now it's like women paying for that shit to keep up with the other women.
Right.
That is getting their shit paid for.
Women is getting loans. Loans, Lou. Loans.
From the bank?
From whoever. However they got to get it. Man, I need $6,000 right now, sis. I'll pay you back. This nigga just hurt my feelings. I got to go get this ass and stunt on this nigga. Well, whatever their reasons is for getting the shit. Yeah. You know, they,
yeah, because buying the booty and titties is like buying a chain and a rolly.
But to them, it's an investment. Because I'm going to land a nigga that really wants this ass.
Yeah.
He going to have to bank the paper.
Yeah, it's like buying a chain and a rolly. Because it's hella niggas. That's an investment. There's a lot of people can't afford that. And they getting it. To not a girl with the booty and titties. So it's just like everybody investment. Everybody's paying just to knock each other. Like, okay, nigga, you bought hella jewelry to knock a bitch with hella fake ass and titties. Like, nigga, y'all could have both not bought the ass and titties and the chain and right. watch, and y'all could have still been fucking with
it
each other.
It still could have been, oh my God, look. Now you are breaking down the matrix, nigga. Because we all just getting this shit to just try to
fuck with each other anyways. We could all not buy shit, and we still gonna fuck with each other.
And why California nigga live how he live, not give a bitch shit? Because you, at the end of the day, you gonna fuck with who you wanna fuck with anyway.
Oh, mamas. That's why West Coast niggas got the most game, because we know. As soon as you buy that wine, we gonna creep up from behind.
Ask you what your interests are.
Who you be with?
Things that make you smile.
What number to dial? You know what I'm talking about? These niggas don't get it. I was just slapping Ice Cube, I Ain't the One by N.W.A.
For real?
That's a blap. He been on
Ice Cube such a legend, bro.
Ice Cube a legend for sure.
Shout out to legend Ice Cube. Rest in peace, AJ Johnson, bro.
Yeah, that's weak. Rest in peace, AJ Johnson. A lot of people don't know AJ Johnson by his name.
Ezell, he played Ezell famously on Friday. Blue and
He was on, what's the name, too? Master P movie.
That's what I Got the Hook Up.
I Got the Hook Up. That's what he's kind of starred in that shit. He did start.
Players Club, just all around, just, you know, very influential in black comedy. And
he's naturally talented, too, because
naturally
I see AJ Johnson at his lowest. I don't think he had
no script for Friday, bro.
You think so?
They might have had some reference lines, but all that, my back. That's him.
Yeah.
He didn't need no script for that.
Oh, mama. He hella funny. I seen AJ Johnson perform at one of his lowest points. Like, you know, he was dealing with things. And still was hella funny. Like, had the crowd rolling. He wasn't even. He didn't have no fit, nothing.
Just him.
Just him, but had everybody rolling. That nigga like DMX of comedy.
I was happy to see him get happy again. Because I was around when them times too, but then I also was around to see him get back happy to be in this shit.
Oh, swear.
Get his feet back under him. I see the pulley. He got up a Benz again. You know. He was starting to get money. He was doing plays. He was doing shows.
For real?
On the way, right before the pandemic.
Oh, okay.
That's why this pandemic shit really fucked off, like how we connect with people, because that's somebody that I love and I would see out and about.
Yeah.
But throughout the pandemic, I didn't see, bro.
Yeah.
You know, and then niggas is just up and then dying, nigga, like.
Yeah, that shit crazy. But the pandemic making me appreciate people more, though.
Way more.
On mama's, because I was on some, like, nigga, fuck everybody, nigga.
I thank God every time I see my niggas.
On mama's, nigga.
Word to my nigga Speedo, shout out. That's a bar from him.
On mama's, though. For sure. No,
it's I thank the Lord. Yeah, I thank the Lord every time I see my niggas.
I like that. Yeah, that's for sure one of them. But yeah, that shit, I don't know. I think a lot of good things is going to come, though. It's a little drought, but I just feel like the universe, the energy, the flow of things, the life. I just feel like people just doing shit. That's why I give a shout out to my boy Simba. You know what I'm saying? He was on the BET Award, Hip Hop Award, Cypher, going dumb. You know what I'm saying? Putting on for the section. So, you know, I just kind of feel like shit like that just...
Simba really be talking that shit, bro.
You know?
I think he gonna be a nigga, a force to be reckoned with, bro.
Yeah.
Just every time I see, bro, I just like, man, I don't see nobody talking like this nigga, man.
Yeah, that's why I love giving people roses before it gets to this point. You know what I'm saying? Because I always felt that way about Simba. You know what I'm saying? So it's like...
Well, I mean, you had a different relationship, bro. You that's your bro. Like, y'all grew up.
Yeah, it's family.
Shit, so.
But it's hella people I grew up with I don't believe in. The fuck? Nigga, there's a lot of people I grew up with. I didn't talk about the niggas highly. I'm like, these niggas weak. Simba really raw. So it's like, you know. Shit, I got a lot of relationships with comedians, but I don't think they funny like you. I just, niggas is
hilarious.
I know, bro. He a comedian. I don't mean I'm saying nigga funny. You know what I'm saying? I like saying shit I mean. That's why I come off mean sometimes, because it's like, I meant that. Like, shit, I thought your ass was not.
Wow, funny. Not with you. I like saying shit I mean, because that's why people think I'm mean. Cause I really mean that shit. So that's why I say I'm mean.
Yeah.
I ain't never heard nobody related like that. This nigga wild. Baby, yeah. It's different.
Yeah, I say what I mean type shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Every blue moon, I fuck up and be like, oh, I didn't mean that. I said it wrong. But for the most part.
You got a little emotional.
Yeah, you know, let the emotions hit you.
Sometimes you just got to take a second, breathe, not say shit.
Man.
Niggas be hurrying up, just ready for the quick rebuttal.
Man.
Nah. I feel like I can say something better.
I've been working on my breathing for sure. That shit work. Like, let me breathe and think.
I was watching Malice in the Palace, and that was the whole shit Ron Artest was talking about. When that whole breathing and thinking, when he was laying on the table, he was like, he was doing what his therapist told him.
Yeah.
Everybody scrapping, fighting. That nigga was laying on the table like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That nigga, somebody threw a beer still cup on that nigga, and that was his trigger.
And that's how life be. You could be working on your breathing.
They can throw a beer on you and that's it, bro. Now I'm talking the wrong nigga for whatever reason.
You know? So, yeah. Life is what you make it.
Man. But that's why you got to keep your mind and your mentals, you know? You got to keep your mentals right.
Oh, mama. Keep that energy.
Mm-hmm. Marshawn Lynch said, focus on your chicken and your mentals.
For real. Oh, mamas. Speaking of Marshawn, shout out Marshawn Lynch and Mr. Fab sliding through the Do Too Much comedy show. You know what I'm saying? Every Friday we do in Oakland. But it's Marshawn restaurant. But that don't mean he's just going to be there. You know what I'm saying?
But he was there this Friday.
Yeah, he was there this past Friday. So it was popping. It was good. Good for the culture. So that was saucy. So every Friday, you know, pull up.
I might have to pull up one Friday.
Boy, that'd be juicy if you slide.
Man,
I'll be juicy if you slide.
I got the whip now. I'll be in the
bay. Slide on my mind.
I got to empty my car out there. I'm like, oh, no. I just thought about the bay.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Oh, I'm about to call Uber. Nigga, park my shit.
But we be having people in the community look out for the cars.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? So we got some people, you know what I'm saying, watching out for the whip. So when you park, you platinum. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, for sure. Yeah, shut up. Yeah. Shut up.
So slide.
Marshawn would do that, nigga, huh? Nigga, this nigga's whole community on park patrol, nigga.
Yeah, every Friday, pull up. And it's for comedians, too. So, like, if you don't even got to be, like, on the show, you could just pull up. If you pull up at 8, you could sign your name on the list, and you can go up. So, it's platinum. So, it's a little place for you to practice. You know what I'm saying? Tell you can slide. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to announce you coming. Just, come up there.
Nah, that's how it's gonna be.
Mm-hmm.
Pop up, show love.
Yeah.
And I really fucks with the bag, bro. Like, I be calling niggas, I be spending the night and different niggas. Like, you know, I be up there really tapped in. Niggas, like, niggas tell me, nah, don't get a hotel, bro. I got a spot. I'm in
You always welcome at our spot. You know what I'm saying? Know. You know. Moms love you. She'll fuck around, make some grits and hella shit, man.
Had a whole Zen lounge laid out. Netflix on. Blanket, humidifier. I mean, that bitch.
Yeah, we for sure gotta line that up. Cause I'm be up there. I'm there every Friday, unless I'm booked and I gotta go somewhere. Right. But the show's still going. Skinny Buff hosted. So my boy Skinny Buff host. So if you platinum big drinks, we got an outside area where you can smoke at and shit.
Okay, go crazy.
Bussing, smoke outside, you know what I'm saying? Listen to music.
If it's Marshawn's spot, he definitely
come on,
he need a smoking section.
Yeah,
he know niggas is gonna pull up, bro.
Marshawn,
think about the community.
Thank you. Man, it's a community thing, man. So every Friday, 9 o'clock, you know what I'm saying? We do the Do Too Much comedy show, so it be jiggy. And shit, what else I gotta announce? The Young OG show this month. You know, we got the 28th. We got it on the 28th.
Go crazy.
You know what I'm saying? So link gonna be in our bio, going crazy. And what else? Oh, yeah, I'm at the Hollywood Improv with D-Ray every Monday, too. So, shout out Monday Ray's, the whole squad. You know what I'm talking about? We there every Monday, too, in Hollywood. So, yeah, man, that's all I got to say. Follow me on social media. We don't do too much.
Man.
Tell you got anything to say?
Shit, man. Just be on the lookout for everything that's coming your way, man. It's a whole lot.
Oh, you on your it's Make More Moves and Announcement?
Yeah, bro. It's a whole, nigga. I damn it. I got one thing. I just saw my paperwork. I can't really talk about it.
Mm.
I'm just juiced, nigga.
For real, tell me when the show over.
It's an NDA, Lou.
Oh, for real.
I'm sorry. No, I'm playing. I'm going to tell you.
Okay. Damn.
That's what an NDA means. I can only tell my niggas.
I got some shit that, you know, the big shit, I can't, you can't announce, bro.
No, for sure.
Because
and you don't want to jinx yourself. Like, I done had the thing with the Comic View shit, bro. Uh-huh. I was promoting the fuck out of this Comic View.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm about to be on Comic View. Oh, I'm about to be on Comic View. They fucked around and only aired 6 of the 30 episodes that they shot.
Damn.
My nigga there, it's going to get, it's, let me do something big. They
yeah.
going to.
Oh, yeah, it's going to come
out. In
the
vault. Teddy Ray in the vault. But yeah. It didn't get aired.
Yeah. Yeah. So the shit, that's one of them.
You just got to be, is it on TV? That's why I wasn't, I don't be juiced, like, bro, not to say, and maybe it's trauma, because mm-hmm. I had that little experience, but when messiness came out, like, uh-huh. I was watching it, I'm like, wow, this really made it to TV.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't, I almost, not to say I didn't believe it, I seen the commercial and all that shit.
Yeah.
But until that shit aired, bro.
That, bro, I think we like that. I think it's trauma with niggas, and then the entertainment business had you like that, because 85 South Show, that's how they feel about the BET Awards. The hip-hop awards, they told me before it got announced, and then, you know, they was like, they was kind of like, nigga, I don't even know, you know what I'm saying? They might cat on us.
Right.
So, I'm like, to hear from them niggas, I'm like, yeah, that's just trauma niggas get. From,
go through.
Go through, because it's like, when you told me, I believed it. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, that's for sure. But that's how I was about my special. Like, I was scared, because I had to do a promo run for my special, and I didn't want to announce the date, because I didn't want everybody to get hyped up about the date. And they hit me like, Lewis, we got bad news. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, I let my shit drop. That's how I did my MTV shit. The nigga just, I just posted the commercial. When I see the commercial, yeah, like, oh, yeah. Go watch it now. I don't like promoting shit. Nigga, I'm traumatized. So, yeah, this shit I just told y'all to come to, that's already in motion. We've been already doing that. So I'm sure what I said, I'm going to be there. And that's going on. The other shit I got going on, I ain't saying shit because I don't know if it really going to happen. And that's where Ted at with his shit, for sure.
It's really going to happen.
That's
good. I just don't know.
Exactly.
The extent that what y'all going to see versus, you know, because I don't give a fuck about shit till it drop anyway.
So oh, mama. Oh, mama. Make more moves than the numbers.
Beyonce taught everybody that. Just drop that shit.
Just drop that shit on mama.
She restructured the whole game.
Yeah. Oh, mama. So, yeah, just pull up on us at the Young OG Show on the 28th.
Yee-hee.
We know that for sure. Thank you all, everybody. We'll see y'all again.